Hi guys, it's Toddy here from Tech Advisor, and the other day I unboxed the Huawei Mate 30 Pro. Now, a lot of you ask that we show you how to put Google Play services on this device because it doesn't come with them out the box. We're going to do exactly that right now. So before we get into it, I do want to caveat a few things first. This is a Chinese model of the phone, and right now it's probably the only version you're going to be able to get. The company is planning on releasing the Mate 30 Pro and the Mate 30 across various markets throughout Asia Pacific and Europe, but we don't know where or when just yet. But in the meantime, if you do want to pick up this particular model, this method should work as I've tested it, and it worked. So let's get on with it. So as I just said, this is a Chinese model of the phone, as you can see if I jump into folders like this. So it is running Emotion UI 10 and Android 10, but it's the open source version of Android. That's why there are no Google Play services on this device. But to get around that, if you jump to the browser and you allow all of the permissions, so you want to allow storage access and everything like that, because you're going to be downloading stuff to the phone storage from the web browser. And then you go to the nav bar, and then you want to go to a website called LZ Play, or LZ Play, depending on where you're watching this, .net. Then you're going to want to tap this button, which, if my Google Translate skills are on point, does say something along the lines of download Google Service Assistant, which actually allows you to download the Google framework. Here's the file. So it's actually an APK file, so it is actually a downloadable app, an installable app. Let's wait for that to download. Okay, so it's downloaded. I'm going to go to the phone's files app, which I've not yet opened, so I'm going to agree to all the terms and good things like that. And I'd say it's best to head to, well, it is actually right here, so we're just going to tap that. I'm going to allow the files app to let you install files. Again, very important. It's just performing a security check. It says, okay, Hi App, which is Huawei's own kind of platform for checking apps and things, doesn't know what this is, but that's fine. We know it's a bit of an unusual source to be installing from. Again, this also needs storage access, so you want to flip that toggle and then just press open. Then you're going to want to tap start at the bottom of the screen here. So then we're going to press activate. And then these are all the different elements of the framework, including, which you can see here, the Google Play Store itself. That's actually the second largest bit after the underlying framework. But once all of these elements are installed, you're kind of good to go. So I'm going to tap this button down the bottom and wait for them all to install. And almost done, and we're done. So just checking things over, making sure everything installed correctly there. And again, what you wanted to see there was all green ticks all the way down the edge. Now it just jumps you straight to this point here. I think it's using a VPN or something to probably get around any kind of Chinese box in case you're trying to install this in China. But yeah, this is now where you put in your standard Google account. You sign into the Google Play Services framework from here. So I'm going to do that, and then we'll jump back to the experience once I've put in those details. Okay, so that is done. We are installed and logged into the Google framework. The phone is just checking everything over, making sure it's all kosher, and then we will jump to the Play Store itself and sign in there as well. So now we have the Play Store installed here in this Chinese build of the Emotion UI user interface on the Mate 30 Pro. So if I open that, you get the standard Google Play UI, standard sign-in procedure as per normal. So I'm going to sign in again, just as I did on the framework page itself. Okay, so I just signed in using my Gmail account. I'm not going to have this particular build backing up to my Google account information, but all the same, we are now into the Play Store, and this is it. This is the full standard Play Store. Now, before you start installing any other apps, including things like Gmail and Maps, it is actually a really good idea to restart your device. I'm not exactly sure why, but it just seems to be that when I restart it, then things work. Otherwise, sometimes you get things like Maps downloading, but then you're not actually being able to run the application. So at this point, restart your device. Okay, so device restarted. If I swipe over, we still have the Play Store. So everything has taken, everything should now work. We should be able to download any app we like from the Play Store as you would on any other Android device outside of China. So if I jump in, first things first, I'm going to get some standard Google apps in there. So I'm going to get stuff like Chrome. and it's just as simple as you would on any other Android phone. Get a few more. And that's about it, really. Once you have installed everything that you want to install, as you would on any other Android device, this should be good to go. There are a few caveats to this whole experience. Things like Netflix, I understand, don't yet work with this Chinese ROM that this phone is running because it's also not an approved device. I'm not exactly sure where the bottleneck is. But until that point, you might find that certain app experiences don't play nice with this method of getting Google services onto your Android phone. Nonetheless, it does work for some of the most important stuff. So hopefully, if all things went to plan, you now have Google Play services on your shiny new Huawei Mate 30 or Mate 30 Pro. If you still have any questions, you can, of course, drop us a line down below in the comment section or hit us up on social media. Also, if you haven't subscribed yet, please consider clicking that button just down in the corner and hit the bell for notifications so you know when we post fresh new content. Hopefully, see you soon. Thanks.